Welcome back to another episode of Dragon Age Origins. I am Pixelated Twix, and we are currently at camp. Last time we left off, we were in Lothering. We took care of a bunch of quests, picked up Liliana. Also, looks like we've got some visitors in our camp. Oh, we also picked up Sten over here, the Canary. So far it's myself, Alistair, Liliana, Sten, Morgan is way over here in the corner, and then we've got these two guys over here, so let's go ahead and talk to them. Ah,
it's good to see you, my timely rescuer. Bodon Fedic, at Hello? Your service. Once again, I saw your camp and remembered the kind offer that you made the last time we met. And is there anywhere safer for a poor merchant and his son to sleep? I think not. I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence. How does that sound? Good? Yes?
Sure, I guess. Let's see. You're free to stay. Mind yourselves.
Wonderful. Thank the kind lady, won't you, boy?
Thank you, kind lady.
We won't be a bother to you and your companions, I assure you. If you should need enchantments, simply talk to my boy. Otherwise, come speak with me.
Okay, well, let's talk to them.
If there's anything I can do for you, please, please tell me.
So what's your story exactly?
Well, if you're really interested, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to tell you.
Yes.
I am originally from Orzammar, the famed dwarven city that lies beneath the stately Frostback Mountains. I was a merchant there, too. Merchant caste. These things are in the blood, you know. You can't just leave them behind. I ran a fairly successful business. Rare artifacts, you know. Old things, grand things. The nobles loved them. Reminded them of the lost glory days, I suppose.
The lost glory?
Our kingdoms once spanned the length of Thedas, from majestic Orzammar to Kalsharok to glittering Darmalin far to the west. They say the gold and silver veins ran so thick through the stone of Darmalin that the entire city sparkled. The Darkspawn took it all, of course. One by one, the old tigers fell, and then all that was left was Orzammar. But we were talking about how I ended up here, weren't we?
Yes.
One day, a noble woman came to my store. She looked around for a bit and then started shrieking in dismay. Apparently, she believed that a pair of braces I had for sale once belonged to her brother. He'd been lost in a cave-in, you see, while on an expedition to clear out the Darkspawn from one of the tunnels running close to the city. They were made specially for him. They're unique, she shrieked. He stole them from my poor brother's corpse. She had me arrested on the spot, of course. Nobles, they're touchy like that.
And did you steal them?
Well, I didn't steal them. You see, I had been paying these castless thugs to venture out into the deep roads for me. The lost tigers, they're full of things that people left behind. Sometimes you can find a treasure, something worth a little gold.
I see.
The noblewoman, she wasn't too happy with the theft of her brother's braces. I don't know what they planned for me, and I didn't want to find out. Bribed the guard that was watching me and took off for the surface first opportunity I got. Never looked back.
I mean, I can't say that I blame him because, let's be honest, I loot dead bodies all the time. Yes, that sounds very morbid, but I do. I also loot crates and things like that. So if somebody leaves something behind, it basically means, you know, it's mine now. That's how I live my life. That's how we all live our life. Besides, this is, well, I don't know when this happened. But especially this time, this is special circumstances. You got to survive out here. But in essence, I'm doing the same thing he's doing, so I can't judge him for that. And now here you are.
Yes, here I am. Now, is there anything the boy or I can get you?
Let's see. You didn't mention your son in your tale.
Ah, yes. I'm married to a fine woman back in Denerim, it's true. She'd give me a son if she could, but that's not likely to ever be. Sandal here. I found him in the deep roads years ago. Abandoned, I think. And he was never quite right in the head. I took him in, and I brought him with me when I came here to the surface. He may not be my blood, true, but I think of him as one.
We left Orzammar.
That's right, boy. Maybe one day we'll see it again.
That was generous of you.
It's not as if I don't benefit, mind you. Turns out the boy's a natural working with enchantments. He might have even been lyrium-addled. I never thought of that before, to be honest. Happens sometimes. He can work an enchantment into just about anything, however, given some time. Could probably open his own shop, if he knew how.
Enchantment!
Well, he does seem to enjoy it, at least.
Okay, well, let me see here. Where is Bodan?
I'm Bodan? Sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected.
Absolutely.
And with your discount.
Okay. All right, so, okay. Well, let's go ahead and grab some of these. We got a little something. We do need some health poultices. We need to stock up. So I'll grab these. And I could probably use some of these lesser injury kits. I'm not going to buy any gear from you, but... see if I can get rid of some things. Let's get rid of that. You know what? Let me go ahead and take care of my inventory because there's no point in you guys seeing all this. That can be kind of boring. So I'm going to take care of that and then I will catch you guys in a minute.
What do you need?
I'd like to ask you something.
Ask away.
What can a Templar do exactly?
Essentially, they're trained to fight. The Chantry would tell you that the Templars exist simply to defend. But don't let them fool you. They're an army. The other main purpose for a Templar is, of course, to hunt mages. To that end, we train in talents that drain mana and disrupt spells.
So, couldn't others learn these talents?
Perhaps. But there usually isn't much of an opportunity. The Chantry keeps a close rein on its Templars. We are given lyrium to help develop our magical talents, you see. Which means we become addicted. And since the Chantry controls the lyrium trade with the dwarves, well, I'm sure you can put two and two together.
That sounds really dirty. So were you addicted to this lyrium?
Thankfully, no. You only start receiving lyrium once you've taken your vows. You don't need lyrium in order to learn the Templar talents. Lyrium just makes Templars' talents more effective, or so I was told. Maybe it doesn't even do that. The Chantry usually doesn't let their Templars get away either, so they can spread their secrets. I'm a bit of an exception. Lucky me.
Is that what he meant, I wonder, when he said that Duncan saved his life? I wonder.
What do you need?
I'd like to ask you something.
Ask away.
Tell me about the Grey Wardens.
Such as they are.
Where are the nearest Grey Wardens from here?
That's a good question. There's plenty in Orlais, but who knows where they might be found. And the nearest Orlesian city is weeks away. If we go north and cross the sea, there's bound to be some in the Free Marches. Again, however, I just don't know where. I don't know anything about Grey Wardens in other lands.
Is there a headquarters somewhere?
Here in Ferelden, there's our compound in Denerim at the palace, but that's it. Loghain will have control over that and be watching it, no doubt. Beyond that, the only place I know of is Weishaupt Fortress. That's the headquarters of all Grey Wardens in the Anderfels, 1,000 miles from here. But I've no idea how to even contact them. So unless we try to get back to the compound in Denerim, I suppose the answer is no. There's nowhere for us to go.
So what happens now that it's just the two of us?
I imagine that eventually the Grey Wardens outside of Ferelden will wonder what's happened. Why there's no contact from Duncan or someone. They'll send someone eventually. Though who knows what Loghain's people in Denerim will tell them. Maybe they won't send anyone. We could try to contact them. But that would mean leaving Ferelden, and even if we did, they couldn't come back with us in time to stop the Blight. So that means whatever happens, it's up to us.
Okay, I have no more questions.
About the Grey Wardens, anyhow. Fair enough. What do you need?
Never mind. Okay, I just, I want to make sure that I save some of the chatter for later. I don't want to inundate you guys with... chit-chat, but let's talk to Liliana. Oops.
Yes?
I'd like to talk.
Well, here I am.
This vision of yours.
I knew this would come up sooner or later. I don't know how to explain, but I had a dream. In it, there was an impenetrable darkness. It was so dense, so real. And there was a noise, a terrible, ungodly noise. I stood on a peak and watched as the darkness consumed everything. And when the storm swallowed the last of the sun's light, I fell. And the darkness drew me in.
But then?
When I woke, I went to the Chantry's gardens, as I always do. But that day, the rosebush in the corner had flowered. Everyone knew that bush was dead. It was grey and twisted and gnarled, the ugliest thing you ever saw. But there it was, a single beautiful rose. It was as though the Maker stretched out his hand to say, even in the midst of this darkness, there is hope and beauty. Have faith.
And this made you want to help me?
In my dream, I fell. Or maybe I jumped. I'd do anything to stop the blight. I know that we can do it. There are so many good things in the Maker's world. How can I sit by while the blight devours everything?
The Chantry says that the Maker has left us. The blight is the Maker's punishment. Will you defy him? No, I wouldn't say that, because I don't think it is. Well, I guess it is, kind of, because of how the Teventer entered the city. It's called the Black City now, but I don't think it was always the Black City, but the Teventer entered it, their version of what heaven would be, and because of them entering without permission, it caused the blight, or they were cursed and it caused the blight. So that's the story. I might be having that a little twisted, so if anyone knows the true lore, or if there's any corrections, please feel free to let us know in the comments below. So, the Chantry says the Maker has left us.
He's still here. I hear him in the wind and the waves. I feel him in the sunlight that warms my skin. I know what the Chantry says about the Maker, and what should I believe? What I feel in my heart, or what others tell me?
Let's see. Are you saying the Chantry is wrong?
They said my ideas were blasphemy. But is it so bad if what I believe gives me comfort? If it could give someone else comfort? I know what I know, and no one will ever make that untrue.
As long as that is the truth, and not just something that you have an opinion about, and based on your strictly just your emotions, as long as it's based on fact, I have no problem with that. That's how she would take it. All right, let's go over here and talk to Sten.
Why are we stopping?
I think we should talk for a moment.
There are darkspawn to be fought. Is this delay needful?
Maybe? I need to know that you can trust. I can trust you have my back.
I am Kunari. I have given my word to aid you. We are not people of idle promises.
That is true. They're very honorable people. I've never seen a Kunari before. Tell me about your people.
No.
Okay, well, in that case, let's keep moving.
As you wish.
All right. Yeah, all right. So let's do as Sten has said, and let's keep moving. No need to waste his time. I won't waste his time. He won't waste mine, right? Okay, so that being said, let's venture forth. All right, so we are going to grab Alistair, yes. Of course. I'm going to try to mix it up a little bit. I definitely need a mage in my party indeed. Right now. Let's go with Sten.
Yes.
I'm going to regret this, but okay. First things first. I think we're going to go ahead and visit Lake Kellenhad. That's going to be our first stop. Maybe not. The game says otherwise. What is that? Oh, I'm dead. I'm dead. Who's dead? Hold on, dude. Let's get you set up here. Ooh, he's dead. Set him down. Yeah. The heck was this? What is this? It's not gonna let me. It says something about bear or something. I don't know. Okay, Sten. Do we have you set up for anything? Let's get you some.
I go.
All right. Character. I think you've been leveled up though. Spells and talents. Yeah, you don't have anything. Okay. All right, let's keep it moving. Oops. Where? Oh. All right, is that it? Return this way? Yeah. Creepy.
What is the name they have for Mother and I? Apostates? Truly, it boggles the mind.
I mean, you aren't apostates. So, what apostate is... okay, basically, let me give you a quick rundown of the lore. Mages end up in circle towers. These here. Something like this. This is a circle tower. Basically, if you are shown to have any magical abilities... You are sent to the circle at a very young age because usually you show magical capabilities when you're young. And that is something that everyone fears except for the Deventers. The Deventers are a special race of people or just faction of people. So you'll learn more about the Deventers in other iterations of Dragon Age. However, in this case... Most of the time, mages end up in circle towers where they are raised by other mages, taught how to own their powers, and then they're given a test at a certain age to see if they indeed have learned the skill, the correct skills, and able to wield their powers appropriately. If they're a risk to society, if they are, they either will... they will either tranquilize them, make them tranquil, or they will kill them. Some of them end up dead. Yes. It sounds very morbid, but that is the case.
Do you ever wonder why the mages built their tower out in the middle of Lake Cullenhard? They have an aversion to practicality or something?
I don't know. Maybe, but maybe for people not to escape. You ever thought about that? Because they're not allowed to leave unless they get permission. So it's almost in prison because they are watched over by the Templars. So it's kind of a prison. Which is actually kind of sad when you think about it. Because they spend their whole entire lives in these towers. Unless they've been otherwise assigned to other tasks. Like the King's Court or something like that. Alright, Shady Thug, let's talk to you. Maybe not, let's talk to you. Deserter!
You have some kind of problem.
No, do you? Oh yeah, I'm here on behalf of the Blackstone Irregulars.
Oh? What is this about?
I'm bringing you in for desertion? I hear you stole some supplies from the guild.
How sad it is to see a Grey Warden manipulated.
How do you know I'm a Grey
but
Warden?
I have no time to straighten this out for you. Men, let's teach the Grey Warden a lesson about trust.
How do you know I'm a Grey Warden?
A bit more dying, please.
I shall do it.
There is no glory in such.
As you say.
Down you go.
And you should know not to mess with a Grey Warden, especially two of them. So the guild supplies, I think I have several of these guys to find. Here's the Mage's Collective. Talk to this guy.
You're the Grey Warden, aren't you? Exactly who I was hoping to meet. I represent a collective of mages interested in going about their lives without the constant scrutiny of the Chantry.
His helm is ridiculous. How do these people know that I'm a Grey Warden? It's not like I'm wearing Grey Warden attire. How do they know this? How can I help you?
Next to me, and in every major settlement, you will find an inconspicuous sack containing requests from mages all over the land who need the assistance of someone skillful and discreet.
Okay. Give me a reason not to turn you into... Do I want to say that? No, let's see what he has.
Thank you, my friend. We have agents in every major settlement to reward you for work done on behalf of the collective. Make us smile upon you.
Your eyes are mesmerizing, sir. Let's see, what is this? Codex. So, the Mage's Collective. Despite the loyalist grasp on the Mage's political community, many libertarians and Aquatarians have begun to see eye to eye with respect to the Chantry's role in a Mage's daily life. A growing number of mages, particularly those whose magic never strays from the Maker's mandate, feel that the Chantry's constant oversight is a burden upon their creativity and their very will, and one that hinders their ability to do their work. These mages, along with a number of hedge wizards who work their arts outside of the Chantry's influence, have formed a shadow guild of sorts, a mages collective, where members can submit requests and have them seen to without judgment. This collective manages to work in relatively secrecy. Their members discreet in their clients anonymous. As of yet, this collective has seen no sanction from the Templars, and there has been no sign that its members are practicing magic of which the Maker would not approve. Still, practicing magic outside of the influence of the Chantry is a dream for some and a dangerous notion for others. And many believe that it is only a matter of time before the veil of secrecy is lifted and the Mage Collective is brought to swift and brutal justice. From a treatise on magic and politics by First Enchanter Josephus. Okay, what do you got?
Very well.
Places of power. I'm not going to read these. Careless accusations. Notice of termination. Thy brother's killer. Herbal magic. Yeah, I'm definitely not reading all of these. That's actually ridiculous. Let's talk to this guy.
Why, bless my soul. What's a distinguished personage like yourself doing here?
Oh, I'm distinguished. Why, thank you. I was looking to get across the lake to the tower.
Don't hold your breath. No one's been allowed across the lake for days. I'm the ferryman. Leastwise, I used to be.
Okay.
Poor old Kester. Out of a job.
Okay, so I can't get across?
Gregor just came down and said, don't you worry, Kester, we got it all under control, we do. Didn't say nothing else. And then he puts Carol in charge of my boat, Lissy, named for my grandmum she was.
Who's Gregor?
He's Knight Commander of the Templars up in the tower. Good man.
So is there any way for me to get to the tower?
You could try swimming, but I don't recommend it. Nasty things in that lake. I reckon it's all them potions they dump in there. Gregor's told me to stay here till it blows over, but I'm telling you, some storms don't blow over easy.
I could convince the Templars to let me in, could I?
Maybe you could at that. I'm sure your mind's all afire now, eh?
Sure. What are your opinions on the Circle?
I reckon it's good for them mages. Gather them all, learn them some proper magics. I know what they say about mages, but the Maker made them for a purpose. If you can't trust him, who can you trust?
You have a point. I can't stay. Good day, Kester.
All right. Keep safe, you hear?
Sure. All right, let's go talk to this guy over here. Actually, let's go in here first. Anything for me to loot? No. All right, wait. I forgot this death root up here. How dare... Girl, you need to do some more cardio. You're running up these hills awfully slow. Okay. In we go. What is this? A bar? A tavern? Disgruntled patron?
Leave me alone.
Okay. What about you? Shady patron.
What are you looking at?
No one.
Drink in peace?
Yep, absolutely.
It shall be done.
I don't have sufficient skill to break in. Wow, I thought I got my thievery up. What's your name? Lorana?
Good day.
Hello. Nope, can't go in there. Let's talk to this guy.
Good day, and welcome to the Spoiled Princess. Is there something I can get for you?
Why is it called the Spoiled Princess?
It was my father's idea. He ran the inn before me, and he named it for my sister.
Is this your sister
she
right here?
She was his little princess. Princess decided the country was too dull for her and moved to Denerim. More glamorous, she said. Well, she was found murdered, robbed of all the trinkets my father bought her with his hard-earned money. My father died of shock and heartbreak. Mother stopped eating, and I got the struggling inn. The name stuck. That's the story.
Wow, he said that in such a callous way. I should get going.
Of course. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Actually, now you know, let's go. Yeah, let's go talk to Carol and see if we can get across this this lake. Yeah, there's no way I'd swim in that. Are you kidding me? Oh. Hello, Carol.
You're not looking to get across to the tower, are you? Because I have strict orders not to let anyone pass.
I'm a Grey Warden, and I seek the assistance of the mages.
Oh, you're a Grey Warden, are you? Prove it.
Prove it? I have these documents here.
Yes. Oh, a Grey Warden seal. Aha! So you're claiming to be one of those. You know, I have some documents, too. They say I'm the Queen of Antiva. What do you think of that?
I think you're delusional. That's what I think. My documents are actually real.
Kill some darkspawn. Come on, let's see some righteous Grey Wardening.
Grey Wardening isn't something you do, it's what you are.
Ugh, semantics. Anyway, it was nice chatting with you. Now, on your way, right now, go.
Persuade or intimidate. I think I have the art of persuasion. Your superior wouldn't like that you've given me trouble.
Oh, really? You think Gregor would be upset with me for not letting you in? Wait, actually, he would. Good point.
Yes, he'll be very mad if you don't let me in.
He's the big guy around here. I bet he could deal with one Grey Warden. Alleged Grey Warden. Well, you want that I should take you there now?
Absolutely, please do.
Come along, I suppose.
And there's two of us, not just one. Let's not forget about Alistair. And then I've got this big Canary with me. He's intimidating.
And I want two men stationed within sight of the doors at all times. Do not open the doors without my express consent. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
I don't even breathe in
there. The doors are barred. Are they keeping people out or in?
Now we wait and pray.
You're Gregor, I assume.
Who are you? I explicitly told Carol not to bring anyone across the lake. We're dealing with a very delicate situation. You must leave for your own safety.
You really should keep your voice down. It's echoing in here. Jeez. Inside voice, Gregor. No, the mages have an obligation. Do I want to say that? Not without a promise for assistance, no. But I seek the mage's help to defeat the darkspawn.
I am weary of the Grey Warden's ceaseless need for men to fight the darkspawn, but it is their right. You'll find no allies here. The Templars can spare no men, and the mages are indisposed. I shall speak plainly. The tower is no longer under our control. Abominations and demons stalk the tower's halls.
This is why we cut the tongues from mages in Parvolan.
I will admit to agreeing with your companion. Maker knows, the Qunari would not have gotten themselves into this position.
That is true. If I remember anything about Qunari lore, they have the same amount of respect for mages as humans do, which is hardly any. And they remove the tongues of their canary mages so they can't cast spells. But I forgot, they have a name for them. I just don't remember what it is. That they're not tranquil. Because if they had tongues, they could still cast spells. What can I do to help?
I have sent word to Denerim, calling for reinforcements and the right of annulment.
The right of annulment?
The right of annulment gives Templars the authority to neutralize the mage circle. Completely.
So you're gonna kill him?
The mages are probably already dead. Any abominations remaining in there must be dealt with, no matter what.
This situation is dire. There is no alternative. Everything in the tower must be destroyed so it can be made safe again.
So you're gonna kill him? The mages are not defenseless. Some must still live.
If any are still alive, the Maker himself has shielded them. No one could have survived those monstrous creatures. It is too painful to hope for survivors and find nothing.
I'll look for survivors.
I assure you, an abomination is a force to be reckoned with, and you will face more than one.
It's fine. I must try. It's the right thing to do.
A word of caution. Once you cross that threshold, there is no turning back. The great doors must remain barred. I will open them for no one until I have proof that it is safe. I will only believe it is over if the first enchanter stands before me and tells me it is so. If Irving has fallen, then the circle is lost and must be destroyed. May Andraste lend you her courage, whatever you decide.
Okay. Quartermaster. Oh, let's loot this first.
Very well.
Apprentice Cowell. Let's talk to you.
I wish this were over. We're running low on supplies, and I don't know how much longer we'll last.
Do you need help?
We need the abominations and demons out of this place, if that's what you mean. If you have anything to trade, that would be helpful too.
All right, let's trade. I don't think I do, to be fair. Oh, oh, wait, do you have potions? Yes, because I'm going to need every last bit of what you got, sir. Every last bit of it. What is this for, this lyrium? Is that to make... This is found in natural powders, ready to be incorporated into potions. I don't know. Do you have stuff for potion? Ooh, backpack. Grab that. Yeah, I don't know. Okay. Oh, there was an injury kit thing. Alright, let me talk to Alistair. Yeah. Grab this, Alistair. Alistair is educated. What else we got? Overpower. Shield wall. Yeah, let's give him dual weapon training, precision strike. I kind of want the taunt, so I'm gonna go here with it. All right, let's head up.
This is the prison for your mages. Ours is not so grand.
Well, I mean, they have to live here for the rest of... What the heck is... Look at that! What is that? That is creepy. My sentiments exactly. We're crazy. We are absolutely insane. Look at all the dead bodies. Look at this. What are we doing?
It shall be done.
Why did I... Okay, something... Okay,
it is
pile
begun.
Of filth. I thought that said something else.
It shall be done.
Lesser ice salve. A sticky snow white salve. No two particles of are identical. What is it for, though? What is it? What does it do? Okay, we got every... Oh, no, we didn't. Apprentices... Something or other. Footlocker. Okay, watch card of the reaching. I'm not gonna read that. I'm not gonna read that. Oh, this way. We don't read on this channel. Sometimes we do. Print another one. You find a few pages from a diary. You know... I'm telling you guys, it's a test, like the summoning. Why else would lessons be canceled? And that outburst in the library with Uldred? An older tome fell to a page on the reaching. I copied what I could before they pushed us out. Ritual note, a sword lowered to strike through and ground. You can't tell me I was supposed to see that. It's too convenient. I'm looking for more. You'd be smart to help. No. And stop asking. I'm not getting into trouble because you again. I don't care what's in the basement, and neither do the senior magi. Everything is about Uldred and the upper floors. The upper room. I don't know what you're digging up, but those tomes are way older than our lesson texts. An apprentice shouldn't touch them. Ritual note. The threads burn before a giant spear raised. He stands alone, so whispers are known false. Nolan. Scribble in the corner. Don't need him. Owen knew the reaching. What? Yeah, I don't know. Maleficarium regrets. I won't go back. Let them hunt and dread finding me. But you, Malise, should not live this life. It would please me if you found a life in the Circle Tower. I left a few things there, mostly stolen from the enchanters. Sell them to fund a new path. The cash is in the study area, middle alcove. Goodbye, Belgrus. Study area. Is this it? This. No, these are bedrooms. This is a bed. These are beds. Not. Yeah. This is a bedroom. Study area. Okay. Another note.
It is begun.
The spot. What do we got? Maker's Wind Dairy. Darcy? I said I'd wait, but it's not just a disagreement. Uldred set abominations loose. One was in my mentor's robe. If you make it here, something in the spot may help you out. The spot. No point in hiding it from the senior mages now. Don't worry about dinner's usual fee for moving his bed. He's dead. Apprentice man. What? This is what happens when you read. I didn't know any of this. What spot? And where's the study? Did Colonel Mustard do it in the study with the candlestick? Oh, jeez. I don't know why that startled me, but it did.
It's you.
It's me.
Come no further. Grey Warden or no, I will strike you down where you stand.
Wynn. It is Wynn. It's Wynn from the camp. What are you doing here?
I am a mage of the Circle. More importantly, why are you here? The Templars would not let just anyone by.
I came here seeking the aid of the mages.
And you were told that the Circle was in no shape to help you, I suppose.
Yes.
So why did the Templars let you in? Do they plan to attack the tower now?
No, they are waiting for reinforcements.
So Gregor thinks the Circle is beyond hope. He probably assumes we are all dead. They abandoned us to our fate. But even trapped as we are, we have survived. If they invoke the right, however, we will not be able to stand against them.
What happened here?
Let it suffice to say that we had something of a revolt on our hands, led by a mage named Uldred. When he returned from the battle at Ostagar, he tried to take over the Circle. As you can see, it didn't work out as he had planned. I don't know what became of Uldred, but I am certain all this is his doing. I will not lose the Circle to one man's pride and stupidity.
Wait a minute, Uldred was at Ostagar and he made it back? Was he with Loghain? Interesting. So what do you intend?
I erected a barrier over the door leading to the rest of the tower, so nothing from inside could attack the children. You will not be able to enter the tower as long as the barrier holds, but I will dispel it if you join with me to save this circle.
Yes, very well. I will help you.
Once Gregor sees that we have made the tower safe, I trust he will tell his men to back down. He is not unreasonable.
Gregor will only accept it if the first enchanter says so.
Then our path is laid out before us. We must save Irving.
Then we should set off immediately.
You want us to assist this preachy schoolmistress? To rescue these pathetic excuses for mages? They allow themselves to be corralled like cattle. Mindless. Now their masters have chosen death for them, and I say, let them have it.
Wow. Hold your tongue, you harpy. You'll do as I say. What the heck? I've made my decision. We will help win.
Have it your way.
Petra, Kinnun, look after the others. I will be back soon.
Wynn, are you sure you're all right? You were so badly hurt earlier. Maybe I should come along.
The others need your protection more. I will be all right. Stay here with them. Keep them safe and calm.
Have faith, we will not fail.
Your confidence is refreshing, though you should make sure it does not blind you to your weaknesses. If you are ready, let us go end this.
Okay, so Wynn is locked. She has to come with us. I know I'm definitely taking yes. Alistair because he is our main tank. I don't know. Should I bring Wynn or Sten? Wynn or Sten? Should I bring Morrigan or Sten? Wynn, Sten, Morrigan. I feel like as a mage, she should... Or Liliana. I don't know. Oh, this is a conundrum. Let's bring... I would like to see the dynamic between Morrigan. Indeed. Although I would like to hear more how Sten reacts to this.
Blast and damnation.
Yes. Let's bring Sten. Yes. Morrigan disapproved of my decision. I'm sorry, Morrigan. We're helping the mages, like it or not. Let's grab this. Oh, who's this?
It is good to see that some wardens survived. We are sorry for the loss of your comrades.
Yeah, Loghain is to blame. He betrayed the king, Kaelin.
We heard about Loghain. I would never have imagined the Tarn a traitor.
Well, he's slimy. I knew he was up to something the minute I met him. Did I, though? How did you find out?
Wynn was at Ostagar. She told us everything upon her return. But why speak of things past? Be careful in there, and stay safe.
He sounds like a tranquil. Can we talk to him?
I heard the Templars talking about chasing down a Malefica yesterday.
So a Malefica, I think, is someone who is a blood mage. I believe. I think so.
I don't suppose this is what you expected the circle to be like, is it?
Not really. This is not a common occurrence, I take it.
I keep thinking this is our punishment for being mages. That's why the Templars have to do away with us. Their swords are like the sword of mercy that sent Andraste back to the Maker.
That's one way of putting it.
We should let the Templars come. Only then can we be cleansed of our wickedness.
The horror of this ordeal has left you unhinged, I see.
I will pray. May we abandon our tainted bodies to find peace with the Maker.
Yeah, she's insane. She's absolutely insane.
I shall do it.
I don't have enough skill. Dang it. Okay. That's not good. We'll have to come back for you.
Look after her, will you?
Yeah, I will, don't worry.
I don't know if she's up to this, especially not after... I just worry.
Not after what?
I was on my way down to the library when I heard screaming, and a demon came around the corner. Its eyes were afire with evil. I was certain it was my death come upon me. I think I screamed. I was so afraid. And then Wynne was there, in front of me, shielding me. It was light and fire, blood and chaos. When it was over, the demon was dead, but Wynne wasn't moving either. I was so afraid she was... gone.
Well, she's probably just stunned.
As I moved to help her, she stirred and coughed. I don't know what I would have done if she had died for me.
Wynne had the wind knocked out of her? She just had the wind knocked out of her then.
Just look after her, all right? Okay. She might be completely fine, but then again, maybe she didn't come away from that totally unharmed.
Maybe. Yes, yes, stop bothering me. Don't worry, she'll be safe with me.
Thank you. And thank you again for helping us.
Okay.
Here we are. I'm somewhat amazed at myself for having kept it in place this long.
You did what you had to do, Wynne.
It made me very weary at times, but I had to stay strong to keep us safe, be prepared for anything. I do not know what manner of beasts lurk beyond this barrier. Are you ready?
I am ready. Destroy the barrier.
All right. Be on your guard.
And we are free and clear to enter into what is going to be a long trek up the tower. I'm going to go ahead and stop this episode here, and we're going to continue on with exploring the Circle Tower and seeing what the heck is going on. And hopefully we can get this matter settled. But until then, I will leave it at that. I hope you guys are enjoying this episode or these episodes of Dragon Age Origins. I'm going to try to at some point double up on the episodes because otherwise this will be way too prolonged. And so look out for those in the very near future. I think this weekend, hopefully I'll be able to start recording double episodes. Anyways, glad to have you guys back with me. Hope to see you again real soon. Talk to you later. Ciao.